Till now, one by one, we had turned our searchlight on Vaisheshika Sutra, Nyaya Sutra, Sushrut Sanhita. Acharya Kanad, as we had pointed out earlier, had discovered laws of motion more than 2000 years before Newton. Well, Rishi Bodhyan, one of the earliest authors of Shulba Sutras, discovered the right triangle theorem, known as the Pythagoras theorem, a few centuries before Pythagoras. Hearing this, you may well ask, if so, why wasn't the theorem named Bodhyan theorem? Well, that's simply because history, including the history of science, was mostly written by the European colonialists. They made it out as if all scientific knowledge was European civilization's gift to humanity. They throttled the few dissenting voices mercilessly. It would perhaps surprise you to know that Shulba Sutras were written as early as the period between 600 BC and 300 BC by acharyas of Sanatan Dharma. They are considered as mathematical appendices to Kalpa Sutras, the texts dealing with Vedic rituals. Shulba means nothing but a rope or a string. These sutras were named Shulba Sutras mainly because the ancient rishis used a simple string or a rope for majority of their geometrical constructions and measurements. Abraham Seidenberg, an eminent American mathematician and historian of the University of California, wrote a monumental research paper in 1978, after 15 long years of research, called The Origin of Mathematics. In this paper, he wrote, "If one includes the Vedic mathematics, one will get quite a different perspective on ancient mathematics." The Shulba Sutras have geometric algebra. As we mentioned earlier, European colonizers were the ones who had twisted out of shape the true perspective. Shulba Sutras consist of a series of 9 geometry texts of on-altar construction: rectangles, circles, squares, right-angled triangles, isosceles trapeziums, parallelograms, and so on. One of the most common mathematical problem that had baffled mathematicians for years was how to draw a circle that had the same area as a square. For the Vedic acharyas, this problem translated into how to build a square-shaped altar which had the same area as a circular altar, and to solve this problem without a scale, they came up with several methods to draw a square. Here we'll show you one method: construction of a square with one side aligned to the east-west direction. Step 1. Draw a line whose measurement is equal to the side of the square. The measurements in those days were in terms of angulas. One angula equals 34 sesame seeds. Step 2. Using the string as a diameter, draw a circle, again using a string. Step 3. With A as the center, draw a circle of an equal diameter. Step 4. Now take a point on the right of AW, perpendicular to the line AW on the circle. Let it be P. Taking P as the center, draw a circle with the same diameter. Step 5. We now draw a circle with W as the center. Step 6. A similar perpendicular point, call it Q, is taken on the left of the line AW and a circle is drawn. Step 7. We now get the 4 intersection points of these circles. A, B, C and D. Joining A, B, C and D, we get a perfect square. These sides will be aligned in the 4 directions. Smart? You bet. Besides, isn't this a marvelous way of constructing a square? The mathematics of Shulba Sutra was available to the builders of the Harappan civilization. No wonder Harappan civilization designed and built one of the most sophisticated set of buildings, streets and the drainage systems in ancient times. Thus, time and time again, Sanatan science has preempted and outshone the Western science.